The system of profound knowledge. Continual improvement pioneer and visionary scholar in academia, Dr. W. Edwards Deming asserted that transformation is needed in a prevailing style of management in any organization. This transformation requires a third eye or a perception from outside. This is what Deming called the system of profound knowledge, which is composed of four parts that are related to each other. 1. Appreciation for a system, 2. Knowledge about variation, 3. Theory of knowledge, and 4. Psychology. 1. Appreciation for a system. A system is a network of interdependent components that work together to try to accomplish the aim of the system. A system must have an aim. Without an aim, there is no system. Furthermore, system is defined as an interconnected set of elements that is coherently organized in a way that achieves something. If you look at that definition closely, you can see that a system must consist of three kinds of things: elements, interconnections, and a function or purpose. The weakness of the management to understand interconnections between parts is the cause why management by objective lost its popularity. 2. Knowledge about variation. Life is variation. Every individual is unique and therefore no two people are alike. Similarly, variation is a given in any business process. Any measure will have variation. If there is no variation, then your measuring device is not sufficiently sensitive or someone is fudging the data. One of the goals of quality management is variation reduction. There are two types of business process variation causes, common and special. Common cause variation may be defined as the random variation of a stable process. Special cause variation may be defined as variation due to a change in the process. It is important to understand and distinguish between the two. Common causes of variation produce points on a control chart that over a long period all fall inside the control limits. Common causes of variation stay the same day to day, lot to lot. A special cause of variation is something special, not part of the system of common causes. It is detected by a point that falls outside the control limits. 3. Theory of knowledge. Companies learn when their employees learn. There will be no knowledge if there is no theory. Deming defined knowledge as the ability to make predictions. Knowledge is built on theory. The theory of knowledge teaches us that a statement, if it conveys knowledge, predicts future outcome, with risk of being wrong. A leader of an organization should understand this theory and therefore should know the difference between a theory and an experience. A decision maker in an organization who employs experience or intuition may have a wrong final decision if the experience is not sufficient or if it is not applicable to the problem being solved. Decision based on intuition rather than applying the framework of a plan do check act cycle may result in a short-term solution but may hurt the overall system in the long run. 4. Psychology. Psychology helps us to understand people, interaction between people and circumstances, interaction between customer and supplier, interaction between teacher and pupil, interaction between a manager and his people and any system of management. In an organization, the leader is coach and counsel, not judge, and he removes obstacles to joy in work. Deming asserted that the most applicable motivation for employees was intrinsic motivation. Intrinsic motivation is one of the two types of motivation, intrinsic and extrinsic. Intrinsic motivators are internal rewards that a person feels when performing a job, so there is a direct and often immediate connection between work and rewards. This type of motivation usually leads employees becoming self-motivated or energized from within to perform their best and make a valuable contribution to the organization or society. On the other hand, extrinsic motivators are external rewards that occur apart from the nature of work, providing no direct satisfaction at the time the work is performed. Deming demonstrated some examples of extrinsic motivation as observed in children. When kids are given prizes such as money and toys after accomplishing something good in school and sports, for example, they, children, absorb to anticipate rewards for any excellent performance. This behavior develops accordingly as they grow older. Their aspiration for tangible rewards becomes their source of motivation. These extrinsically motivated individuals usually work very hard to make money. Anyone that derives meaning from extrinsic sources of motivation brings detrimental effects on his or her self-esteem. Furthermore, intrinsic motivation is built in the process of doing rather than in incentives that may be generated when the process of doing is successful. A fundamental source of this type of motivation is the gratification on a job well done. Deming supported the said argument by elaborating the roles of parents to their children. The loving mother, the kind teacher, the patient coach, can, through praise, respect, and support for improvement, reinforce the child's dignity and self-esteem. Children feel good about themselves when they learn how to master a new activity. They become more intrinsically motivated. They develop self-esteem and confidence. They develop self-efficacy. Their work is meaningful, and they will make improvements in what they do. Deming emphasized that the principles in his philosophy for quality improvement, called the system of profound knowledge, apply to all organizations, small and large, manufacturing and service. It is therefore concluded that upper management will always learn from the system of profound knowledge. Integrating such a theory with total quality management makes the entire system sustainable.